السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. سامعني؟ شغال؟ السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أنا مش سامعني. طب الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. ثم أما بعد، يعني it's very difficult for anyone to talk about any subject without reflecting on what's happening in Palestine. And you know, it's a great lesson to all of us. يعني هذا درس عظيم وأيام من أيام الله سبحانه وتعالى. We talk, we make دعاء. But actually, you know, you all heard the بيتين الشعر. يا عابد الحرمين لو أبصرتنا لعلمت أنك في العبادة تلعب، من كان يخضب خده بدموعه فنحورنا بدمائنا تتخضب. البيتين، يعني these two piece of poem, we have a great Imam Abdullah ibn Mubarak and another Imam al-Fudail ibn Iyad used to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Mecca and Medina, focusing only in ibadah. And Abdullah Mubarak, one of the great ulama, he went for jihad. And he sent these two pieces to al-Fudail ibn Iyad, telling him that you are the man or the worshipper of Mecca and Medina. You're going there and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is a great act of worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But it's kind of you are playing compared to the true jihad that we are doing. Whoever dyeing his beard, his lihya, with tears while he's praying, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, again, not يعني, undermining the dua or ibadah, but our neck is dying with blood. And subhanallah, you know, the jihad that our brothers and sisters and, you know, kids, elders, the stories that we hear from Gaza, and again, when I'm saying Gaza, I speak about the city, but we should speak about Palestine. All the time, occupied Palestine. This is the term we should use. And we don't talk about one group, or Hamas, or whatever. We speak about the Palestinian resistance, al-muqawma al-Falastiniya. So we have Palestine al-muhtalla, occupied Palestine, and we have the Palestinian resistance, al-muqawma al-Falastiniya. And this, inshallah, victory will come sooner or later in our life, in our kids' life, in our grandchildren's life. It will come, no doubt about it. But what happened that, and what they really did to us, and may Allah reward all of them, all the Palestinians inside occupied Palestine, and the Palestinians outside too, just for our sake of our brothers here. What they did is إحياء روح المقاومة. إحياء روح المقاومة. To revive the spirit of resistance. This is the most important result that we have from this. That, you know, we feel good. We feel that, yes, we can. You know, yes, we can. With our little resources, with the siege, هذا الحصار الظالم الغاشم, yes, we can resist. We can stand up and say, no, we will not accept to live with humiliation. We have Antara, before Islam, he said, لا تسقيني كأس الحياة بذلة بل فسقيني بالعز كأس الحنظل. يعني don't give me the glass of life with humiliation. Don't make me live as a slave, but I'm willing to die. I'm willing to taste the worst taste of any food or any life, but to live with dignity. And this is the most important lesson that we have to reflect on and to remember all the time. The second point is, this is great, alhamdulillah rabbil alamin, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala علمنا في القرآن ألف لام ميم أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون. يعني in the beginning of Surah Al-Ankabut, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that the people will think that they will claim the shahada, will say, we are Muslims, we are mu'min, without actually growing through trial and fitna and tests. So this is a test. Test for them within occupied Palestine, and test for us where we live in this country in peace and we have mashallah everyone has whatever most of us have good life alhamdulillah rabbil alamin are we going to interact with them are we going to think about them are we going to actually help them by all means that we can do from religious point of view and from legal point of view this is what we need to do this is a test for us imtihan lana madha sanaf'al fi hadhihi al-azamat hal sanushahid at-tilfaz am sanasna' al-ahdath Are we going to see the news every night? Or we're going to make the news? You know, the people who make the news, they don't watch the news. Only the people who are living with no value, just watching the news. This is why, inshallah, through Ramadan, is a good opportunity for all of us to make the news, to make something, again, that please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and support our brothers and sisters, not only in Palestine. Every Muslim on earth, we have our brothers in Hind and Hindustan, in India, where they are suffering. And again, we should not be selfish. Don't think only about your own problem. You have to think about the whole ummah. Not only Muslims. You have to think about the suffering of every insan, every human on this land, including the native of this land. They did not thus, the European, لم يكتشفوا أمريكا. They did not discover America, North America and South America. It was there. And many people traveled. We have many ancient traces of their existence. So we have to support, to stand for Haqq. You worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Haqq and you have to stand for Haqq. The third point. And I appreciate, I thank our government, Canadian government, for resuming the support to UNRWA and to support our Palestinians, brother. And we ask them to go back to old Canada 25 years ago. Most of us who came 25 years ago, we loved Canada and we want to come to Canada for what? Because Canada was known for peacekeeper. Always Canada will send troops with the United Nations to support and to spread peace in any zone that have conflict. Any conflict zone, the Canadian forces was there and was well respected from everyone. I have many stories from Canadian friends, not Muslims. They said, I went for any place. Of course, they go for bars, you know, to drink. And they, you know, the people will give them hard time and they start to bully them and thinking they are from different citizenship. I will not mention which one. And the moment they say, we're Canadian, I'm so sorry. You know, we love you guys and so on. So Canada, we want Canada as Canadian first and as Muslims, we want Canada to go back to be peacekeeper. We want Canada to be neutral. We don't want Canada to be, at least if Canada cannot stand with justice or beside justice, stay in neutral state. Stay as we know Canada as a peacekeeper. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect all of us. So inshallah, during this time between me and Sheikh Amjad, may Allah protect him and give him barakah, that the time for Khatira will be not 10 minutes, not 15 minutes until Sheikh Abdul Aziz comes back from the office. So whatever he show up will stop. So this is why the train of thought will not be, you know, so if I stop, don't be upset, because what I'm going to do inshallah this year, we already talk about, he didn't show up yet. So. We started long time ago, I think in 2017, what I called Al-Falah wal-Khusran fi al-Qur'an. I believe that the whole Qur'an, the Qur'an is talking about two main categories of human. Al-Muflihun wal-Khasirun. The successful one and the losers. And through the whole Qur'an, you will find many actions that human will do to be with the muflihin, or they do certain actions and they will be among al-khasirin, successful one and losers. So inshallah, I will review what we mentioned in the last few years just to refresh your memory. And for those who join us for the first time, they are aware about what we mentioned in the beginning. So we start with Surah Al-Fatiha. Surah Al-Fatiha have two parts. Second, first half talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the second half talks about al-insan, human. And Allah mentioned almost five things about insan. Number one, إياك نعبد ها وإياك نستعين. So the main thing about insan is إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.